As many of you have asked about my CNC dowel deal bits, I'm gonna try to explain a bit difference and benefits over the classic ones. This is the brad point bit, usually made of chromium vanadium steel, and it has a center spot to prevent walking when it penetrates the surface. This is the twist bit. It is typically used for metal, but a lot of people use it in gear surfaces too. They are made of high-speed steel, and they also have two cutting edges, but they don't have a center spur. And the last one is the drill bit this is all about. They are made for being used in CNC machines or drilling and taping centers, but more and more people are using them in column drills or 3D rotors as mine. There are a lot of types, through hole, blind hole, left or right hand, and of course different diameters. You can use them in all kind of good and good base composites. It is made of super strength steel and it has two precision round cutting edges and a center spur. They also have a special coating to help keeping the bit from collecting resin, pitch and other residues. Okay, let's try them so we can see the results. Let's start with the hard plywood and the brad point bit. I'm making a blind hole and then a through hole. As a rule, we should use a block under the plywood to avoid splintering, but I'm not using one here, so we can see the real difference between all the bits. As you can see, the bit does the job, but the back does not look good. As you already know, the bigger the size of the bit, the lower must be the revolutions of the machine. I'm using a manual 2-speed drill that can work at 650 and 2000 RPM. So in this case with small bits, I'm gonna go with a faster one. Let's continue with the twist bit. It has the disadvantage that it is not as easy to find the center point, but the result is also good. You can see it looks better, but still not perfect. Finally, these are the CNC dowel drill bits. First, the through hole. It goes smooth and centered, and as you can see, no splintering at all. Let's try now the blind hole. Perfect. Here you'll see it better. The brad point bit made a lot of splintering in the back. The twist bit did it so much better, and the CNC bit did a perfect job. Let's do now the same test in a more delicate material, MDF with melamine in both sides. With the brad point bit, the upper side is perfect, but there is a bit of splintering in the back. With the twist bit, as it doesn't have a center spur, the material is slightly tamped. The back is surprisingly well. Finally, with the CNC bit, both front and back are perfect, as you can see. In my opinion, for a column drill and using these materials, this bit is the best, but they are not easy to find. In fact, I couldn't even find them without a flat part they have for the connection. If you're planning to use them without a drill chuck like mine, you must be careful of keeping this part between the legs, as I'm doing here.